In this video, I'm going to provide a brief overview of mathematical methods for solving the inverse problem and localizing ERP generator sources. There are two main classes of source localization techniques, equivalent current dipole approaches and distributed source methods. In equivalent current dipole approaches, we assume that we can account for the data reasonably well with a relatively small number of equivalent current dipoles. The locations and orientations of the dipoles are fixed for a given subject, but the magnitude of the signal at each dipole varies from millisecond to millisecond, giving us a source waveform. The locations, orientations, and source waveforms are estimated by means of an iterative error minimization approach. You typically start with a random set of locations and orientations. On each iteration, you use a forward solution to compute the predicted scalp distribution from the model. You compare this with the observed scalp distribution and see how much error you have. This is done for every time point, and the aggregated error across time points is called the residual variance. The locations and orientations are then adjusted slightly to reduce the residual variance, generating a new model. This procedure is iterated until the residual variance reaches a low and stable level. This is just a simplified overview, and there are many variations, but I'm not going to go into the details because this approach has largely fallen out of favor. The main problem is that the researcher needs to decide on a bunch of parameters, such as the number of dipoles, and this can have a big impact on the results. As a result, different researchers may end up with very different solutions. Also, given noise in the data and imperfections in the forward model, it's possible for the best fit solution to be quite different from the true solution. You can read more about these issues in this online chapter from my ERP book. The other main method is called the distributed source approach. This is a generalization of the basic model of voltage propagation that we've been talking about all along, where the voltage at a given electrode is equal to the weighted sum of all the source waveforms. But instead of a small number of dipoles, we take a structural MRI scan and tessellate the cortical surface into thousands of tiny patches. We then assume that each patch is a tiny dipole. We know the locations of the patches from the structural MRI data, and we assume that the dipole for a given patch is oriented perpendicular to the cortical surface. Now, instead of just having a handful of sources, we have thousands of sources, but the structural MRI data tell us the locations and the orientations. We just need to figure out the magnitude for each patch at each moment in time. And we can do that fairly easily by translating our basic model into a simple system of equations. Here's a simplified view of the patches in a single slice through the head. Just as in our original conceptualization, the voltage at a given electrode is a weighted sum of all the sources at a given time point. For example, the voltage at electrode 5 is computed by multiplying the activation at source 0 by the weight between that source and electrode 5, plus the activation at source 1 multiplied by the weight between that source and electrode 5, etc. This would be a very long equation, and we can express it more compactly using a summation symbol. This equation now represents every electrode N, every source S, and the matrix of weights between each source and each electrode, W. Remember that the weights are just constants, and we can estimate them from a structural MRI scan. We can take our summation equation and convert it into vector notation. The vector of the voltages at the electrodes, E, is equal to the vector of source activations, S, multiplied by the matrix of source to electrode weights, W. If you're familiar with linear algebra, this should be pretty obvious. If not, don't worry about it, because it's roughly analogous to standard algebra. By expressing the forward solution this way, it's easy to see how we can compute the inverse solution. We're trying to solve for the magnitude at each source at a given time point, given the observed voltage at that time point and the weights. To do this, we just multiply both sides of the equation by 1 over W, which is the inverse of the W matrix. We can then rearrange the equation, and now we see that S, the vector of source magnitudes, is equal to the vector of observed voltage values, E, multiplied by the inverse of the matrix of weights, W. So, we can directly compute the magnitude at each patch of cortex from our observed data and the weights, which we can estimate from a structural MRI scan. We now have everything we need to solve the inverse problem. We have E, the vector of observed voltages, and we have W, the matrix of weights. We can just multiply E by the inverse of W to get the activation level for each patch of cortex. This is done separately for each time point. Isn't this beautifully simple? I still remember the day that Anders Dale explained this to me when we were both grad students at UCSD. back when we both had a lot more hair.